So, before we sing Roll with Sharon, yesterday it struck me in rehearsal that I hadn't been thinking about the words and the music. And everyone in this choir, they have a special gift that they give me. And one of the gifts that I was missing was Biddy. And she's always the one who prompts me to think about the words that you're singing. And so she's definitely been in my mind over these past few days. And as we were singing, I looked at their faces as we were singing Rose of Sharon. And I didn't see the connection that Rose of Sharon was Christ. It was me being very demanding and asking so much that we weren't really thinking about the words. And it's been a long time since I've had this in my life, and so I'm really glad to have that again. And one of the things about the Rose of Sharon is if you go and try to figure out what is Rose of Sharon, how it is connected to Christ, there's two questions that come. One, which flower is the Rose of Sharon? And two, how is it connected to Christ? Because the Rose of Sharon is only used in the Bible once, and that was by Solomon's bride-to-be. She refers to herself as the Rose of Sharon, the lily of the valley. So commentators have been trying to think, what is the Rose of Sharon? What was this really beautiful flower that she was trying to prepare herself to? And so they go and they say, well, Sharon was a plain in the Middle East, and it was a very, very fertile place, and it was known for its fragrance and its beauty and all of these flowers. So everyone's trying to figure out, what is the Rose of Sharon? But Rose of Sharon has been attributed to a lot of flowers across the world. Every culture has its own Rose of Sharon, and each one of those roses have a unique quality. Some Rose of Sharons can bloom even when there is snow on the ground. Other Rose of Sharons are used as a healing and medicinal purpose. So I think one question is the answer to the other. Everyone is so focused about what is the Rose of Sharon, which flower is it? Just like today, so many people are focused on who is Christ and who has the right view of Christ, when really everyone should be appreciating the variety that we have and everything that unites us. So one question is the answer to the other. Which one was the Rose of Sharon? Who shares? The important thing is that everyone in the world has a Rose of Sharon, just like everyone in the world has a right to Christ.
Yeah. Amen.